Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by EduPal, home of the $5 courses. Check out my Excel class, Excel Formulas, The Dirty Dozen, at tinyurl.com/EduPal5. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1923, label line chart midpoint with descriptive text. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Simple little chart here, three series. We have a beginning and an end. You see, every time I press F9, the rand between causes this to change. And the question from Abhijeet is, how do we make the midpoint show whether we are up or down? So as the lines change, the label moves, and the label text changes as well. All right, so let's walk through this one. This is Excel 2013. Which brings up some interesting things. First thing, I want to create a chart from this data. I'm going to go to recommended charts. They'll never recommend what I want. All charts, line charts, line charts with markers. And this is really cool in Excel 2013. Now they give me both series, so I don't have to say, hey, you chose the wrong one. Go choose the one with three series instead of the one with two series. That's a nice improvement in Excel 2013. All right, we'll click on the legend. And so we want the legend at the top. Click on the chart title, press delete to get rid of that chart title. All right, so there is our data. Let's add some data labels. All right, so we've got the beginning point and the end point label, but now we need to get that extra thing in the middle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a new column, and that column is going to be called average. Why an average? Because that way I will be able to get the label at the right spot in each case. All right, so we'll copy that down. And you see we now have a third point, but that's really not what we want because there's not a third point there. I just need that point to show up to get the label to be at the right spot. So here's what we do. The first click selects that entire blue series. The second click selects just that one point. And then I click the paint bucket, I click the marker, I click marker options, boy this is really buried, and say none. Down here, the gray line, same thing. First click selects the whole series, second click selects that one marker, click none. Orange series, first click whole thing, second click just that one marker, and then none. New in Excel 2013, we can have the labels come from cells in the worksheet. So not just value, but value from cells. So over here off to the side, I'm going to build my labels area. The labels area for the beginning point and the end point is going to be exactly what we have. But for the midpoint, I'm going to use the difference. So 503 minus 504, we'll copy that down. And then I'm going to use a custom number format. Control 1, custom. And for positive numbers, we're going to say in quotes up space 0 semicolon. This is for negative numbers, so we'll say down space, that's in quotes, 0. Notice I didn't put minus 0 there, so we're not going to get a negative. And if it is actually 0, we're going to say flat, so if there's no change at all. All right, so now we have down 2, up 3, down. I'll press F9. See, so right there we go from 516 to 516. It is flat. Now the trick is going to be getting these values to show up instead of these numbers here. All right, so this is going to have to be one at a time, unfortunately. So here's our blue line. I'm going to change the text color to blue to match the line. And then over here, value from cells. Really important, by the way, that you do not uncheck value first. You have to add value from cells. And this is series A, so it comes from here. Click OK. And then uncheck value. Choose the gray series. The gray series is series C. So value from cells comes from these cells. Click OK, and then uncheck value. Finally, the orange series. The orange series is series B. Value from cells, these three cells here. Click OK, and uncheck value. All right, so now we have the marker at the beginning. We have the marker at the end. No marker in the middle. And this text coming from the extra range. Of course, it's always nice to hide that extra range with the chart itself. We'll press F9, down 1, up 3, flat. Oh, I forgot the colors here, so select that series, font color orange, and the gray, font color gray. All right, there you go. So now the labels match the line color, No marker in the center, the label moves, and we're good to go. Well, hey, I want to thank Abhijeet for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel. MrExcel.com.